Welcome to Alder Creek. That was terrible. Let's try that one again. Okay, 3, 2, 1. Okay, welcome to Alder Creek. So this is my 97 Subaru Legacy. I bought it for $300. Actually, one of my buddies had it. But what I did is I took it from being a low rider and then lifted it. So I'm currently sitting 5 inches taller than what I had. Went out and rallied with it in the field, and sure enough, I blew my radiator to pieces. So today, I'm gonna show you how to replace a We're gonna replace a radiator and a thermostat in 15 minutes, if I can ever learn how to talk. So up next on Alder Creek, stay tuned. The history on this thing. This thing is a true champion. This thing is sitting at 312,000, almost 313,000 miles. And I do believe this is the stock motor. And how it has made it, I don't know. I've been told these are WRX STI seats. I really don't know. They decided to put this giant thing in there for all the drifting we do in four-wheel drive. But, yeah, I'm pretty much unricing it. Somebody decided to take off the roof rack. That was pleasant. Made some super awesome dents for me to deal with later. but probably the most proudest thing about this thing is this on the front of it. So this was actually from the same guy I bought the car from. This is actually off of a 79 F-150. And I actually modified it a little bit and made some brackets to actually mount this guy onto the front of this. So, shall we start? So I kind of cheated. Oh, this may be interesting. Stay. All right. So, radiator, this fella right here. And I already drained what was left of it, even though almost all of it boiled out somewhere in this general vicinity. So first thing, gotta drain it. Hopefully yours doesn't end up all over the floor like mine did. Yeah. But from there, I'm gonna show you how it all takes. You have this bolt here, it's 12 millimeter. This bolt here is also a 12 millimeter. These two come off. These two back here, that's a 10. And then that guy's also a 10. Take those two guys out, and then you have to remove this guy. And then the one on the bottom, but we're doing the radiator thermostat. Damn it, both, yes, yes. So let me show you underneath of here where he is. So there's your where your thermostat is. So all we have to do is take out this bolt and this one over here, and we will have a nice little green shower, and then should be able to yank everything out and throw it in. So, let's see. All right, so one thing I forgot to mention here, I'm trying to pull out the radiator, and I was hoping that the wires going up to the plugs for the fans, the cooling fans on the radiator, that I could pull it up far enough to actually be out and be able to unhook them, but I was not able to. So you can see here I'm fighting with it and fighting with it forever. you actually pull up on the tab to pull it out, kind of a little bit different on some rigs, like Ford rigs I know are different,
But you can see I'll fight with it here and fight with it. It's pretty good stuff going on right here. Yeah. Yep. Dumbass. Probably should have crawled underneath. Would have been a lot easier. But nope, I soaked myself. Hey, look at that. I got it out. Oh, man.
We're out. So, after I got nice and dirty, a nice shower, what you have to do, take this guy. We actually have to take these off. These two, these, that guy, those two. We'll take those off and put them on the new radiator, along with this hose and the housing for that thermostat. And we got to put a new one of those guys on. Oh, yeah. Okay. 4 minutes in. Not bad. This is how this guy is sitting. I'm just gonna take everything right there, put it on this guy. Got some clips that are somewhere. Should have came in the box. Boom. So these little guys. So all they do is pull them out. And all they do is you just slide them on to your radiator. Like so. Boom. And then you just thread right into them. And you're good to go. If you do end up losing these, you can always put a nut on the backside of it if you had to. They're not very cheap if you want to get them. They're just a few bucks. Okay, so those look like M10. My hat is nice and soaked, and so is my impact now. That's great. What you want to see, but it's a DeWalt. So, hopefully it doesn't blow up. So what I did, I just got these guys started. Now let's tighten down the impact. Okay, that one didn't start. Okay, that's super duper cool. Oh, it's strict, that's why. That's okay. We're in business. I can say I had never really been a big fan of Subaru. I always just kind of like, I don't know, but I've been sure impressed by this thing. That'll work. Okay, so this guy left. Oh, I do not like this guy. Not too bad though. Okay, we'll stick this guy back in here. Okay.
have your hose for your reservoir, your top piece, put that guy back on. Throw this guy out before he dumps everything. Okay. Now, let's put it back in. Okay. So, get your radiator all set up here. All the new stuff, put it on. Got the right orientation. Nothing's smoking yet, so that's usually a good sign. Stick it down in here. Be kind of gentle. You don't want to put a hole in it. Plus, some things are going to probably be a little bit tighter than they were before. Never knew with no new aftermarket stuff. Sit in little slots at the bottom there. I'll show you. So I don't have my light on right now, but you look down here at the very bottom. You can't see anything. Okay. So you look right down here. Right there. Right. You can see it down there on the frame. Right about where my finger is pointing, right there. There's a little rubber grommet, and that radiator actually will sit inside of there. You got to make sure that's placed in there, otherwise it's going to bounce around and probably eventually fall out. Or go into your belts, and that would just be a ton of fun. So, make sure those are set in place, otherwise you're not going to be very happy in a short amount of time. Okay, so you got those in there. Side, I don't know what's going on here yet. Something doesn't feel quite right. I better make it. There. That's it. Perfect. Okay. So, now, let's go back under the beast. Okay, so we're underneath it now. Here is the old thermostat, which there was nothing wrong with it, but it's just easier to do it all at once. Then you don't have to drain it again. I mean, this thing cost me like $20, and then I don't have to worry about it. It's a lot easier. It should just pop right out. May have to grab a screwdriver. Oh, there we go. Okay, actually, we're pretty darn clean right there. Not really too bad. You know, it's a nice little spare to have. But here is a new one. Right here. This guy. Oh, if I can actually get it. In view. So, you got this real ceiling ring. This guy sits up here like this. Actually, he's got a little race we can sit it right here. I hope you guys know, this is the first time I've ever even done this. I didn't go through. You want to talk about looking up videos? Nope, this is pretty much this all in, all at once. Blind. So, there we go. Actually, stick this guy. It sits right inside of this. There's a little groove inside here and just slips right on there. Like this. Okay, now that guy's like that. Make sure you put him in the right way. He goes in like this. If you put it the other way, don't quote me on it, but I do believe your thermostat will not open. Don't quote me, I'm pretty positive though. Look it up for yourself, you know, I'm a jack of all trades, not an expert. But the bloody thing, I can do this for you guys and show you how to do it. Okay, now find your bolts that you have randomly set somewhere. Make sure it's sitting good. Looks pretty darn close. See, it's all sitting in there. Really nice. Okay. Let's go and get a good seal. Line this guy up. All
Now, you really gotta push that thing in there. Pain is all for you guys. Okay. Oh, yeah. Yeah. There. Nope. 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 Okay. Try it again. Don't you love you get a plan and going together? And then life happens. It's like, oh, man, I was really hoping for that. Okay, that's cool. That's cool, man. Ugh, the grommet is just a little tight. Ugh. Maybe someday we'll get it here, folks. Ugh. No, something's sitting right here. Something is not going on here. How much thinner is this old guy? Welcome to mechanics. Nothing ever goes as planned. So, let's take a look here. Here's the old one. Here's my new one. I don't know if you can see, they're real close. But I think the outside diameter is just a little bit bigger. We're gonna try it. We're gonna keep trying. It's never easy. The thread's in there. Come on, man. Come on, Subaru. Don't be like that. Don't be like that, man. Just a hair. There. Stay. Now where'd the nut go? Boop. Okay. There. Started. Okay, you guys can find me. Oh, there's my little nut. Boop. There you go. I don't know about you guys, but I really, really hope that it is sealed tightly. I don't want to pull that out again. I really hope you guys can seal this. Okay, going together. As you can see, I torqued it down properly, according to DeWalt. Perfect. Okay, so everybody send a prayer. And hopefully it doesn't leak. Okay, back on top. Have that on this. Okay, so let's button up the top real quick. And throw some fluid in it, we'll be done. Okay! So, top hose on here. Tighten it down. Good enough for county work. These little guys just kind of slip right over the top, like so. There are two bolts. There we go. Nope, wrong ones. These two on top, 12s. And then you always want to break off your bolt.
like in the last 3 minutes and then get it really stuck in your frame. So the part about 15 minutes, we may have just screwed the pooch. Yeah. We're still gonna keep going though. Just right after this. So you just saw, I just snapped off a bolt on the front of this thing in the last bit of finishing this thing up. So, we're gonna fix it. We're not gonna try to skip over the top of it and deal with one bolt holding down the radiator. So first thing you wanna do is get yourself a nice strong IPA. I prefer Elysian. Elysian and some other Washington beers. They have great beer in Washington. It's the hops, man. So that's step number one. Step number two, hang on. Step number one's still causing some issues. Okay. So, step two, you gotta get some nicotine. Big importance. You wanna stay calm and not be mad at things. I mean, it is Japanese. I mean, you know, World War II, Pearl Harbor, there's still a little bit of tension I have. Just saying. I mean, if you're Japanese, you know, we're cool, but still, you know, just saying. This thing has a tendency to piss me off. But after you get some nicotine, what you'll want to find is Jesus Christ Ease Outs. It's not a brand, it's just the ones that he used. Now, these things are just ancient. They've been laying around the farm forever. I just dug through one of the drawers and found them. But, kind of a lot of different ways you can do it. But, I like, see, you got a bunch of different random stuff in here from whatever Jesus was using back in the day. And of course the one I was looking for has ran away. Oh, there he is. Okay, so this guy is roughly about the right size. Kind of an old school, straight square. Drill a hole, pound it in, turn it out. Well, I'm gonna try that. No promises though. Okay, so, got here, little spring punch. I highly recommend one of these. This guy was like 12 bucks on Amazon. By far the best. I've had Fastenal, I've had Harbor Freight. This thing is awesome. It has worked every time except for maybe a handful. It's worth the money. So what you do is go right in the middle of the bolt that's broken off, which I still can't believe I did. Punch it, give yourself a good little hole to start in. Then you're gonna wanna start stepping in bit size. It's not real big, so I'm going a little bigger than I probably would, but I think it'll be just fine. Well, it probably won't be, but that'll be for your guys' entertainment. So we'll start with this dude. You're gonna drill all the way through it. Uno!
Is it?
Yeah, it's still there. So, I'm gonna see just if I could go with the one. Yeah, that one bit will do it. So now, that's in there. Could take a little hammer and snap the thing in there. So it's really stuck in that bolt. And what's it doing is it's pushing itself in there and actually driving it into the old bolt. And then I'd be able to go, it's actually solid right now. Yeah, and then we'll go grab, you know, a pair of pliers, vice grips. Whoa, steady. You could even get a socket and put it on it. That's what I'm going to try to do. No, I probably don't have any of that small. So, vice grips. Yeah, vice grips sound good. Oh. All right. Nope. A little too tight. Okay. So, make sure you're going the right way.
Hey, look at that. Look at that, Jimmy. We're making her happen. Ooh, it's getting really tight. I don't like that. Don't get tight. Don't break off this thing. Come on. Well, we're getting there. We are getting there. Look at that. Textbook extraction. That right there, friends, is how you do it. By the way, I'll put money on it. That I bet that's an M8 bolt. M8 by 1.75. 1.5. I don't know. I got a box full. We'll find out. Hang on. The M8 by 1.25, excuse me, by 25 millimeters long. So, let's see if he's going to work. Oh, yeah. It's a little tight. There's some rust on it. I think it'll work. We'll see if I break that one off now. That'd be really funny. So, three. Go to two. Three is too crazy. This little impact has so much power, it's unreal. What in the fuck? Okay. Well, you might let that one dry. Yeah. Okay, that's cool. Okay. There we go. So, we're down. So, just gotta hook up the clips for the fans, plug those guys back in, fill her up, and we are done. We're not close to 15 minutes. It's all about the ride. Reservoir back in. Coming. There you go. There we go. Stick your line back into your reservoir tank. Okay. Now, did it. We are ready to fill this bad girl up. Or boy, you know, whatever. Just one of the two. All right. So, I have another little trick to show you guys. So, before my buddy would own this, we watched how people were filling this thing up and having issues with burping and getting all the air out of the system. And they're using this funnel thing that was able to lock down on top of where your radiator cap would go on to make sure it's sealed. Well, it was like 20 some bucks and I didn't have one. So, you know, I'm pretty inventive. So I got a funnel here. This is like $1.50 and just some duct tape. No, it's not pretty. Is it professional? Hell no. But that's how shit gets done. May not be pretty, but it'll run. So, stick this guy on here. Bam.
and then start getting a whole bunch of antifreeze, and we'll find out if she's gonna leak or not. I really hope it doesn't. That's the bolt was enough for today. Okay, so. Have good old Napa brand antifreeze. Full strength. I'm not a fan of 50-50. It's just, you get way more for your money doing it this way. And I don't use distilled water, even though everybody's going to go, oh my gosh, you gotta use distilled water, use distilled water. I have seen stuff run for 20, 30 years without using distilled water. I mean, it's going to keep things a little bit cleaner, but you rinse it out a few times or flush out your system every 10 years, and you're fine. Unless you're really hard on it, I don't think you're going to have any issues. So let's find out if we're going to leak or not. Oh, yeah. I also have absolutely no idea how much this takes. So, as we sit there with a great big air bubble. Oh, geez. Okay. So, there is a cool little thing on these. There's one little thing I do like these radiators. So, let me show you. Take a screwdriver. Check out this dude. So this guy is actually a little vent. So you open them up. And this, there we go. See? Boom, gone. So this will actually go and let all the air come out of this thing way easier. Very impressed with that little addition. So let's keep on stuffing her full. I'll typically go gallon of antifreeze, gallon water, gallon antifreeze, gallon water, until she's full. Here's the first gallon. Hey, 250 funnel, right? Not leaking at all. Not bad. Okay, we're slowing down here. Must be getting starting close to full. Yeah, I can see it coming in over here. So we're getting close. So, at this point, now we got some fluid in this thing. I'm sure as soon as I start it, it's gonna take a lot real fast. So, we're still flowing. It's still flowing in right now. Try and release as much air as possible. But at this point, you're pretty much done. It's definitely not quite as fast as I would like to. That's how it goes. I don't know how much it is in the book, what it says for a mechanic to do it, but not bad. I hope you guys had fun. I did. I'm going to finish this up here, and we'll get it fired up and see how we did. So, thanks, guys. Thanks for hanging out. There you go. That's it. 313,000 miles and still going. Have a great day. Thanks for watching.